Good morning, everybody. Today we will see our second lesson, that is A Simple Philosophy, who is written by C.T. Let's start our lesson with the introduction of the author. In 1854, C.T., the chief of the Native American Squamish tribe of the state of Washington, addressed the letter reproduced below to President Franklin Pierce of the United States. Actually, what happened in 1854, Chitul, who was the chief of the Native American Squamish tribe, who was the chief of the tribe of the state of Washington, he addressed the letter reproduced below to President Franklin Pierce of the United States. And in that letter, the pioneering white people were taking over more and more of the North American continent. And in that letter, he has mentioned that the pioneering white people, the dominant white people, were taking over more and more part of the North American continent from the Native Indian tribes as they progressed westward, because they are progressing westward, and they were taking over more and more part of the Native Indian tribes. This letter expresses the simple philosophy of Chief Seethul's people. And in this lesson is in the form of a letter, and that particular letter expresses a simple philosophy of Chief Seethul's people. Chief Seethul'cha people-chi, lokan-chi, sadha tattvajnanacha madhye sangitlele ahe. It also describes the decline and resignation of the Native American people. And it is also mentioned in this letter, the decline and resignation of the Native American people. And indirectly warns the white people of the future environmental and social consequences of human recklessness. So now we will begin our lesson. These days we speak of living with nature and the need to maintain an environmental balance almost as though these were new ideas. Nowadays we are speaking to live with nature. Everyone is speaking to live with nature. And the chief need to maintain an environmental balance almost as though these were new ideas. And we should treat them as new ideas, because this is the need of our, we can say, to live with nature is the need of the hour. The truth is that many aboriginal cultures, aboriginal means beginning culture. The truth is that many aboriginal cultures have always lived in harmony with nature. And the truth is that, the fact is that many aboriginal beginning cultures have already lived in the harmony of nature, while their more civilized and developed counterparts have destroyed the earth in attempting to mine its wealth. But on the other hand, They were attempting for mine, and they treat mine as their wealth. That's why they have destroyed our earth. Nothing illustrates this fact better than this letter. And according to writer, that no one or no thing or nothing can illustrate the fact, the reality, better than this present letter. The great chief in Washington sends word that he wishes to buy our land. So what happens? Once the great chief in Washington, he sends word, and in that word he wishes to buy our land. And in that letter, he wants to buy his land. He wants to buy our land. The great chief also sends us words of friendship and goodwill. And along with that, the great chief also sends us words of friendship and of goodwill. आणि त्या चिपने मग त्या पत्रामध्ये असं सुद्धा लिहिलं, म्हणजे असं सुद्धा कळवलं, म्हणजे मैत्रीचा हात पुढे केला, चांगल्या गोष्टींचा हात पुढे केला. दिस इज काइंड ऑफ हिम, सिन्स वी नो दॅट ही हॅज लिटिल नीड ऑफ अवर फ्रेंडशिप इन रिटर्न. अँड वेन ही सेंड्स देम द वर्ड्स ऑफ फ्रेंडशिप, ऍट दॅट टाइम means the writer think that this is kind of him. So kharokhar khub dayalu ahe, since we know that he has little need of our friendship in return. And at that time we know the fact that he has also a little need of our friendship. If he sends us the words of friendship, then he has also need, a little need of our friendship too in return. But we will consider your offer, for we know if we do not do so, the white man may come with guns and take our land. So further writer says that, but we will consider your offer, means his offer was to buy our land. His offer was to buy our land. And still the writer says that, we will consider your offer. I mean, ichchitas tumcha offer cha vichar karu. For we know, because they know, the tribe know that if we do not do so, if we do not consider your offer, then the white man will, they will come with guns and take our entire land from our possession. So the reason behind that, to considering that offer, is that if we do not consider the offer of the great chief, then the white people may come with guns and they will definitely take our land. What Chief Sitel says, the great chief in Washington can count on means depend on. The great chief in Washington can count on as truly as our white brothers can count on the return of the season. So the great chief was of the opinion that in Washington can count as truly as our white brothers, means they, the great chief was depend on truly on white brothers, can count on the return of the season. And they were also count on the return of the season. My words are like the stars, they do not set. And he was of the opinion that his words are just like the stars. Just like the stars move from one place to another, likewise, his words are also do not set. Okay, they were also, his words are also moves. His words are also do not set. How can you buy or sell the sky, the warmth of the land? The idea is strange to us. So further, Chief Sheetal says that here, how can you buy or sell the sky? To me, Akash, kyunwa? Akash kasa kharidi karal, kyunwa kasa vikal? The warmth of the land, ya zaminichi ji ub ahe, the warmth of the land, how can you buy or sell? The idea is strange to us. That particular idea of buying sky or selling sky is quite strange, quite amazing to us. We do not own the freshness of the air or the sparkle of the water. Likewise, in that letter, it is also mentioned that we do not buy, we do not own the freshness of the air as well as the sparkle of the water. Apan kadhihi havichi shuddhata, म्हणजे आपल्या मालकीची करून घेऊ शकत नाही. तसंच पाण्यामधलं स्पार्कल सुद्धा आपण आपल्या मालकीचं करून घेऊ शकत नाही. हाऊ कॅन यू बाय देम फ्रॉम अस, देन हाऊ कॅन यू बाय द एअर, द वॉटर ऑर द वॉर्म्थ ऑफ द लँड, बिकॉज नो वन कॅन गेट द ओनरशिप ऑफ द एअर, ऑफ द वॉर्म्थ, देन ऑफ द वॉटर. सो हाऊ कॅन यू परचेज, हाऊ कॅन यू बाय ऑर सेल दीज ऑब्जेक्ट्स, means this is the question which has been asked by Chief Sheetal in this letter. How can you buy them from us? So how can you buy all these things from us? We will decide in our time. When the time will come, we will definitely decide about that. Every part of this earth is sacred to my people, and as far as this earth is concerned, every part of this earth is sacred to my people, is holy to my people. Every shining pine needle, every shady shore, every mist in the dark woods, every humming insect is holy in the memory and experience of my people. So the nature or the earth itself is holy or sacred to my people. Likewise, every shining pine needle, then every shady shore, every mist in the dark woods, and every humming insect, means everything in the nature is holy, is sacred in the memory and experience of my people. Means everything of the earth, everything in the nature is holy. Everything in the what I can say on the earth is holy and sacred. So how can you buy or sell those things from us? I hope that you are getting it. Okay. We know that the white man does not understand our ways. Further, he stated that we know. They were very sure that the white man does not understand the ways of the Indians, the ways of the Chief Sitthal. Chief Sitthal cha ja paddhati hotya tya nichitas white people la kiwa white man la laksha denar nahi yachi khatri tyanna hoti. One portion of the land is the same to him as the next, for he is a stranger who comes in the night and takes from the land whatever he needs. So one portion of the land is the same to him, is the same to him as the next, for he is a stranger. He is a stranger, just like a stranger, and he will come in the night and takes from the land whatever he needs. Means he will come to this earth just like a stranger, and whatever land he require, he will buy that land within a night. The earth is not his brother, but his enemy. And this particular earth is not his brother, but this earth is his enemy. And when he has conquered it, he moves on. And when he will conquer that earth, this earth is not his brother, but this earth is enemy of him. And when he will conquer the earth, then definitely he moves on from this earth, or from this land to that land. He leaves his father's graves behind, and he does not care, because their tendency is that they leave their father's graves behind them, but they do not care. म्हणजे त्यांच्या मागे काय राहिलेलं आहे, त्यांनी त्यांच्या वडिलांची जी आपण ग्रेव म्हणतो, ग्रेव, ती ग्रेव सोडलेली आहे, तरी त्यांना त्याची काळजी नाही. ही kidnaps the earth from his children. He not only buy the earth, but he kidnaps that earth from his children. He does not care, but he does not care. Whatever he do, he is not repentant at all about his deeds. His father's graves and his children's birthright is forgotten. Whatever his father's deed was there in the past, and whatever his children's birthright, all these things have been forgotten by him, that stranger. His appetite will devour the earth. His appetite means book. His appetite will devour the earth and leave behind only a desert. Means his appetite of buying the entire earth will devour, will destroy, and he will leave behind only a desert. त्याची जी लालसा आहे, इच्छा शक्ती आहे या पृथ्वीला विकत घेण्याची, ती या पृथ्वीला नष्ट करून टाकणार आहे. त्याची जी लालच आहे ती, आणि पृथ्वीला केवळ आणि केवळ वाळवंटाचं स्वरूप आणून देणार आहे. द साईट ऑफ युअर सिटीज पेन्स द आईज ऑफ द रेड मॅन, अँड व्हॉट एव्हर साईट द सिटीज हॅव, दोज सिटीज पेन्स द आईज ऑफ द रेड मॅन. Those pains feel to the red man feels that pains of the cities, but perhaps it is because the red man is a savage and does not understand. But red man is considered as a savage, and that's why the red man does not understand what are the pains of cities. There is no quiet place in the white man's cities. Means there is no quiet place. No place is quiet in white man's cities. जर आपण व्हाइट मॅनचा विचार केला, तर त्यांच्या कोणत्या शहरामध्ये आपल्याला शांत जागा मिळणार नाही. नो प्लेस टू हिअर द लीव्स ऑफ स्प्रिंग ऑर द रसल ऑफ इन्सेक्ट विंग, अँड देर इज ऑल्सो नो प्लेस इन द सिटी ऑफ द व्हाइट मॅन. इन दॅट प्लेस वी कॅन हिअर द लीव्स ऑफ स्प्रिंग ऑर द रसल ऑफ इन्सेक्ट विंग, म्हणजे तिथं आपल्याला स्प्रिंगच्या सीझन मध्ये लिव्हचं रसल ऐकू येणार नाही, खळखळाट ऐकू येणार नाही, किंवा इन्सेक्ट विंग सुद्धा ऐकू येणार नाही, म्हणजे इन्सेक्टचा आवाज सुद्धा ऐकू येणार नाही. बट परहॅप्स बिकॉज आय एम सेविज आय अँड डू नॉट अंडरस्टँड. पण कदाचित त्यांना असं वाटत असावं परहॅप्स बिकॉज आय एम सेविज म्हणजे मी क्रूर आहे, मी रानटी आहे अँड आय डू नॉट अंडरस्टँड आणि मला हे सगळं समजत नसावं असं त्यांना वाटत असेल. द क्लॅटर ओनली सीम्स टू इन्सल्ट द इयर्स बिकॉज द क्लॅटर द रॅटलिंग साऊंड ऑफ द लिव्ज ओनली सीम्स टू इन्सल्ट द इयर्स. कारण की जो रॅटलिंग साऊंड आहे तो साऊंड जोपर्यंत आपल्या कानावर पडत नाही देन मीन्स इट इज ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ अर्थ. म्हणजे हा जो लेसन आहे दिस पर्टिक्युलर लेसन इज बेस्ड ऑन द अर्थ. नाव डेज वी आर डिस्ट्रॉइंग अवर ओन अर्थ ऑन द वॉट वी कॅन से ऑन द नेम ऑफ डेव्हलपमेंट वी आर डिस्ट्रॉइंग इच अँड एव्हरीथिंग. वी नो देर आर नंबर ऑफ ट्रीज विच हॅव बीन कट डाऊन बाय द पीपल डे बाय डे बट नो वन केअर. सो ऑन द नेम ऑफ डेव्हलपमेंट वी आर डिस्ट्रॉइंग अवर ओन अर्थ and this particular letter is based on that theme of nature. And what is there to life if a man cannot hear the lovely cry of the whippoorwill or the argument of the frogs around a pond at night? And what is the value of our life if we do not know the value of whippoorwill or the argument of the frogs around a pond at night? Then what is the importance of this life? What is the importance of this life? जर आपण किड्यांचा आवाज ऐकू शकत नसू, जर आपण बेंडकांचे डराव डराव रात्रीच्या वेळेला ऐकू शकत नसू, तर आपल्या जीवनाचा काय फायदा? The Indian prefers the soft sound of the wind darting over, means moving rapidly, darting over the face of the pond, and the smell of the wine itself cleansed by the midday rain or scented with pine. Because Indian prefers the soft sound of the wine which darts away from the face of the pond, and the smell of the wine itself cleansed by the midday rain or scented with pine. The air is precious to the red man, and as far as the air is concerned, that air is precious to the red man. For all things share the same breath, the beast, the trees, and the man. Because for all things share the same breath. Pratyekala toch shwas paahije ahe, mag to beast aso, trees aso, ki manushya prani aso. Everyone needs breath. The white man does not seem to notice the air he breathes. But the white man doesn't care about the breeze. Because he only wished to buy the lands. He only wished to destroy the earth. And that's why he doesn't know the value of breath. Means the same breath that requires the bees, the trees, and the human being and every living being. But the white man does not seem to notice the air he breathes. Parantu white manasala, white manla, the breath is valuable. Cool. Like a man dying for many days, he is numb to the smell. Like a man dying for many days, he is numb to the smell. Manje janu kai to badir zalala jhalela ahe, he has become numb to the smell. To badir zalela ahe, tyala kontyahi bhavana shillak rahilela nahi. So here I would like to stop. Tomorrow we will finish this lesson. Thank you very much for listening me patiently. Thank you.